Okay, part two of remembrance. We're going into the embodiment exercise experience. Okay, who is not familiar with breath work? That's what I need to know. Please put it in the chat so I know that who has not ever done breath work. And don't feel silly. Okay, I'd rather know that you've never done breath work. And we do have some amazing breath work master practitioners, so y'all are just gonna have fun with me tonight, okay? Because I usually open up like, you're like, oh, I guess I can kind of do whatever the hell I want because I literally follow no rules. Okay, is Diana the only one that hasn't done breath work? Everyone? Okay, Adina, perfect. So there is, this would be kind of good for everybody, even if you breathe every single day. I'd love for you to put your hand on your belly for a moment. And I'd love for you to just breathe in and feel your belly go up. And then as you breathe out, feel your belly come back in. As you breathe in, your belly goes up. And as you breathe out, your belly goes down. Okay. This is how we're supposed to breathe. Allow this to just be really comfortable, be in this moment of you breathing, having your belly go up and down. Okay. This means that we're actually filling our lungs up. Okay. And as you breathe, we're going to be having you breathe deep into your belly like this. Okay. Not just in your chest. Most of us breathe up in here. If you breathe up in here, you're going to feel like you're going to hyperventilate. Okay, I really want you breathing with your belly down here. The other part is we're gonna practice a little bit of fire breath, okay? So fire breathing, how I like to explain it is breathing through the contraction of your abs, okay? It's actually a contraction. You're contracting the air out. So as you breathe out, you're contracting your abdomen muscles and pushing the air out. And then as you relax them, the air fills back up. So let's go ahead and practice some quick breathing in and out of the nose. It doesn't have to be rapid, but just practice as you breathe in, filling your belly, and as you breathe out, have it be a little bit forceful and contract your abs. Kind of give you guys a little example. Okay. So I bring that back to your guys' reference because we're just going to be breathing. I'm going to have you guys do different breaths. Some will be through the nose, some will be through the mouth. There will be things that I have you guys do where it requires coordination. And you're going to be like, oh, and you're all in your head, like, oh my God, 4 breaths, 8 breaths, what is this? Relax. Okay, just relax. It's okay if there's a little bit of lack of coordination. Find what works for you. Okay, don't worry about doing it perfect. If I have you guys do something with your arms or your hands and you don't know what you're doing, you can't do anything wrong. Okay, you can't do anything wrong here. You get to fall into this place and you get to make whatever modifications you feel called to make. To make it so that you can be part of the experience, okay? Attempt to do what I'm saying, please. But if there's anything that you get in your head about, find your rhythm, find your flow so that you can go into a place where you're just with your breath. Because the whole experience tonight is about being with your breath and being in the here and the now, okay? And I'm gonna be playing some songs. I'm going to be running you guys through a meditation and a visualization. It'd be a fun experience. And you just get to be here and just open up to whatever it is that wants to come through. Even if there's some resistance or there's fear, whatever it is, this is about that relaxing the nervous system. These are the moments in life, right, that I'm talking about when we forget. Anything that's constricting is us forgetting, us not trusting. Oh my gosh, am I doing it right? Did I fuck it up? Is anyone looking at me? So you're already in practice of relaxing your shoulders, not giving a fuck, and being like, I'm just here to experience. Mikkel's not judging me, right? I'm not judging me because I'm choosing to remember. This is part of the practice. And this can be something that you guys take into your morning practices. I hope that this inspires you to bring this into something daily that maybe you do in nature, or you do when you're stressed, or you do when you're forgetting. So let's go ahead and close down our eyes. Connecting to your breath, connecting to this moment. Teach me, grandmother, show me the way. Deep breaths in and out of the nose. Don't be afraid to allow the breath to be audible. Hearing your breath in and out of your nose. Filling the life force energy inside of you. We're gonna start with the fire breath in and out of your nose. Go ahead and begin the rapid breathing. Remember the contraction. As you breathe out, it's contracting your abs, pushing the air out. Shoulders down, attention to the center of your brows, your third eye. Breathing in and out. Allowing yourself to regulate with spirit, with source. We're almost there. Keep breathing. We're warming up our body, warming up our kundalini. Warming up that serpentine energy inside of our spine, from the root, the sacral, the solar plexus, to the heart, to the throat, to the third eye, to the crown. Opening up all that energy. That's what this breath is. Deep inhale, holding the energy and breath at the top. Holding this energy in, squeezing the rectum, your sex organs, your root chakra, and forcing that energy up, up, up through the crown, tongue to the roof of the mouth. Release the breath. Inhale, exhale. We can be sold. Our ideas are deep. You're creating a new body for yourself with this breathing. Creating a presence reality. This is you remembering, you getting out of your head, letting ego fall to the side. We have to override the ego. And breath is the quickest thing to bring us into presence. Go ahead and bring your hands together out in front of you. Connecting your fingertips. Your hands are at the height of your heart. All of your fingertips connected together. Not your palms, keeping your palms apart, feeling the energy. It's almost like you had a ball of energy or fire in between. You could say water, since we're in the energy of water. But letting your fingertips connect. All 10 fingertips connecting, but not the palm. And what you're gonna do is we're gonna breathe in for 8 counts through our mouth. Okay. And then out through our nose, one big breath. In for 8, filling our belly 1/8 at a time. And then out through our nose. So in through our mouth for a count of 8, out through our nose, 1 big breath. Keeping your eyes closed, continue breathing at your own pace, your own count of 8 in and your own big breath out. Eight in, 1 breath out. 8 in through the mouth, 1 breath out through the nose. Feeling your fingertips connected. Allowing all of that chi energy to flow. Through the most sensitive part of our body. Attention to your third eye as you count. Let everything float away. If there's anything that you do think about, focus on the energy and frequency of gratitude with your hand at your heart center. Illuminate what that frequency feels like as you count in 8. Out through the nose. Keeping your breath going. At whatever pace feels comfortable. Trusting this moment, letting everything fall away. Let it be a meditative experience. You're almost there. To join forces and unite with my soul family, to sing songs of love and freedom to be. Big breath in. Holding it at the top. Stilling your nation. Attention to your third eye. Releasing your breath, releasing your hands. Be in this new body. Breathing in and out. What it feels like to relax, to remember. Our next posture, we are going to be making a new hand. I don't know what this is called at this moment. I usually do in yoga. Our pointer fingers are straight up, same with our thumbs. Our hands are going to be interlaced. Okay. Most of the time in yoga, this goes straight up above our head. But what we're going to be doing with this hand posture is we're actually going to be putting it behind. So put your arms behind your back. This is going to be our scorpion toe. This is going to honor the fact that we're in Scorpio season. What it's also going to do is force our chest up, open our heart. The straighter your arms, the better. If you can get them off of your back, the better. But if they have to relax on your back, that's totally fine. We are going to begin breath of fire through our mouth. Opening our chest, eyes shut, but gazes up. This is a powerful breath, clearing energy. This is a shorter segment, so push through this one. Allow yourself to be in a little bit of the uncomfortableness. We're opening up meridian systems, clearing energy. Breath in and out of an O mouth like you're breathing through a straw. If it's a little intense, you can bring it to a medium, but push through. Allow yourself to breathe. Allow yourself to clear.
You're tuned to Dawn FM, the middle of nowhere on your dial.
Big breath in.
So sit back and unpack.
Holding it at the top.
You may be here a while. Now that all future plans have been postponed, and it's time to look back on the things you thought you owned.
Release your breath, release your arms.
Were you high or just stoned? And how many grudges did you take to your grave? When you weren't liked or followed, how did you behave? Was it often a dissonant chord you were strumming? Were you ever in tune with the song life was humming? If the pain's living on when your body's long gone, and your phantom regret hasn't let it go yet, you may not have died in the way that you must. All specters are haunted by their own lack of trust. When you're all out of time, there's nothing but space. No hunting, no gathering, no nations, no race.
And
heaven
breathing.
Is closer than those tears on your face. When the purple rain falls, we're we're all bathed in its grace. Heaven's for those who let go of regret. And you have to wait here when you're not all there yet. But you could be there by the end of this song, where the weekend's so good and he plays all week long. Bang a gong, get it on. And if your broken heart's heavy when you step on the scale, you'll be lighter than air when they pull back the veil. Consider the flowers, they don't try to look right. They just open their petals and turn to the light.
Keep breathing,
are you
deep
listening?
Breath.
Real close. Heaven's not that, it's this. It's the depth of this moment. You don't reach for bliss. God knows life is chaos, but he made one thing true. You gotta unwind your mind, train your soul to align, and dance till you find that divine boogaloo. In other words, you gotta be heaven to see heaven.
Take a big breath in. Go ahead and take your feet out from underneath you. Stretch your legs out for a minute. Shake them out. Give yourself a break for just a moment. We got two more breath postures, and then we're going to lay down. Stretch. Give your legs a break. Trust this process. Trust that when we're priming you for a visualization, we're allowing your body to relax. Go ahead and find yourself seated in whatever position is most comfortable. If you want to cross your legs, you need your legs out for this one, that's fine. We're going to do a breath of a four count. We're going to do four in, four out through the nose, four in through the mouth, four out through the nose. Even breaths in and breaths out. Go ahead and begin. Whenever you're ready, four in, four out. Four in, four out. Around and around on this wheel of life. Breathing in and out, life, breathing in and out, love. Connecting all that is and embracing here and now, here and now, here and now. If we only seek, we won't find. Cause seeking makes human hearts blind. If we only seek, we won't find. Cause seeking makes human hearts blind. Be open. Deepening more and more into this moment, into trust, into joy, into spirit. Calling in your higher self as you breathe. Pour in.
Circling around and around and around on this wheel of life. Breathing in and out, life, breathing in and out, love. Connecting what I is and embracing here and now. Pure and true gratitude streaming from me to you, whole life. Praying for awareness, now is the time to unite, unite. Pure and true gratitude streaming from me to you, all life. Praying for awareness,
for in, for out, attention to your brow.
Unite.
Allowing this to be meditative.
Universal heart.
ego will not want to be here now. Your higher self is completely okay with where you're at and what you're doing. It's present. This is a practice in presence. Want to be able to make it through life? Practice breathing. You'll understand the relationship that you have with life. Do you resist it? Or can you surrender to the moment, to the now? Big breath in. Holding at the top. Releasing your breath. Normal breathing. We've reached the part of the visualization. We have primed our bodies to relax. Short 10 minutes. Your nervous system has been cued to just be, to be in the passenger seat, to let your soul drive for a moment. Go ahead and find your way down to a laying position, flat on your back, preferably no pillow under your head if you can. If you are kind of propped up and breathing, that's okay too. If you're just kind of laid back in a really relaxed place, just make sure your spine is straight so your neck is clear so you can breathe. We're gonna go into a beautiful visualization. This is the higher timeline activation part that we're going to be venturing into. Being able to relax your head completely. And as you lay here and you get ready for this part, find a circular breath in and out of your nose or in and out of your mouth, preferably in and out of your mouth. And oh mouth, oh breathing. Allow it to circulate. There's no pause in between this breath. I'm going to keep cueing you to breathe through this breathing process. Breathing in a circular pattern. You may lose my voice at certain points, and that's totally fine. You may go off into never, never land, and that is fine. But if you can bring yourself back when you do to the cues, awesome. I'm going to be running you through some questions, some activations through this breath. So your most important job is to keep breathing. Breathe in and out of your mouth. Keep this circular breath going, in and out. I'll have you slow down the intensity of it at the very end, where you can relax, but allow this to have some force to it, some flow to it, like the ocean. We're harnessing the new moon and eclipse energy. And in this moment, we invite in your guides, your angels, your ancestors to support you, to guide you, into helping you remember who the fuck you are. You, my love, are a divine being on this planet, a reincarnated wise soul. An ascended master. an angelic being, a spiritual being having a human experience. You are here to help serve humanity. You are here to experience joy and pleasure. So we call in your guides and your angelic team so that they can help you remember your path. Keeping the breath going, feeling your guides come in right now. And calling in your higher self, that wise, infinite version of you that always knows the next right step. Let's invite her in. Breathing. Allow yourself to find your heart center. Allow yourself to envision a light where your heart is. Keeping the breath going. What color is this light? And as you start to let the light take shape and form, let it turn into a flower. Seeing this flower bloom in its radiance where your heart is, you start to follow the stem down. Continue to breathe. You follow the stem down and down and down and down to the roots. And you're in the ground, in the root system of your heart. And as you start to follow these roots down, you find that there is an egg of some sort that these roots are wrapped around. Keep breathing. You allow yourself to let one of these roots crack that egg open. And you start to enter inside of this egg that's inside of your heart. And you start to see that inside this egg is your true essence. Your remembrance of your path, your remembrance of your royalty, your remembrance of your abundance, your remembrance that you can have anything that you desire. And inside this egg, keep breathing, you find a piece of paper, a note to yourself. Your higher self wrote to you. Keep breathing. And on this piece of paper, there was a letter of remembrance for your path and your divinity and what you are supposed to create this lifetime. And so you decide to pick it up and you read it. What is it that you are supposed to be doing this lifetime?
Anna Poo.
what are all of the things that you are supposed to experience and have and be and do? Letting all of the answers keep coming in, because it's infinite. It's not just one thing. There's an abundance of things. Keep breathing. And then you realize on the back of this paper, there's one more note. And it says the most important thing to remember. And it says, have fun, be joyful. Take risks. And while you do it, have fun, be joyful. What does that mean to you? What do you need to do in your life so that you can start to have more fun and be joyful right now? Keep breathing. Willing to release so that you can be more joyful and have fun and take risks while you're having joy and fun? What needs to go? And release it. Let it go. Let it go. If it happens in your mind, it can happen in life. Let it go with ease. Even if it seems big, even if it seems hard, in this moment, just let it go. Keep breathing. In and out of your mouth. You travel back outside of the egg. And you're in the root system again of this beautiful flower. And you start to travel back up the stem and into the flower itself. And this is where you find your superpower. My love, what is your superpower? What is the thing that makes you come alive? What is the thing that brings you joy? What is the thing that brings bees to your nectar? What is your nectar? Keep breathing in and out of your mouth. sinking in your superpower. Sinking in this soul nectar of yours, letting it drip into your heart, into your chest, allowing you to remember who the fuck it is you are. This is who I am. Breathing into this, letting the nectar, your soul nectar, fill your body, your superpower, your brilliance, your magnetism, your joy, all of the things that make you radiant, let it fill your body. Allow yourself to feel gratitude for it, for you, for your life, for everything that you've experienced. Let the soul nectar continue dripping onto you with all of the gratitude that you can have for your life, for your bravery, for your tenacity, for your wisdom, for your love, for your heart. This is part of your superpower. This is part of your nectar. Letting it drip and fill your body. Continue to breathe. Continue to feel grateful. Continue to feel like you are your own superhero, that you are unstoppable. And as you are illuminated in your own brilliance, in your own soul nectar, I invite you to call upon your angelic team, your high council, your ascended masters around you. Bring them in front of you in this moment. Continue breathing. Bring your angelic team, your high council in front of you, and allow them the time and space to say what it is that they want to say to you, to help you remember who you are supposed to be and experience this lifetime. What is that message they have for you? What do they want to help you remember? Continue to breathe. Continue to let them talk to you. Let them remind you who you are. Let them illuminate that path for you through visions, through words, through imagery. Who are you? Let them show you. Who do you get to be? What frequency do you get to attune to? Namastasye, 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 namo namaha. Continue to breathe, breathing in this wisdom. Jagadambe Janani. bringing yourself back. Bowing to your guides, thanking them for the messages. Coming back, 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 back. To a place where you're more aware of your body. Allowing your breath to go in and out of your nose now. So you're no longer breathing out of your mouth. Letting your breath slow down completely. Where you're sinking back more into this moment. Starting to become aware of the room that you're in. Knowing that you just went on a little soul journey, gathering some messages, gathering some insights. Knowing that there's a path for you to take. Knowing that you are unstoppable. Knowing that you can do it all. You just have to make time and space for moments like this. Taking some breaths in and out of the nose that are a little bit deeper and slower. Maybe a little bit of an audible exhale. Starting to move your ankles and your wrists, bringing some movement into your body. Knowing that you just completed a really beautiful journey. Starting to come back completely to this moment, blinking open your eyes. For any of you that would like to grab your journal and write down anything that came through, please do. For any of you who just want to kind of be in this space, move slow. I'll play a song. Move as slow as you need to. No need to rush. No need to rush up. Be, breathe. Love you, Michelle. And the ocean waters swallow all that is to be. Any of you have shares and you want to share in the chat, you're so welcome. Anything came through, or you just have a little message you feel complete. You know, let all of you move as slow as you need to. I love you, Corey. Thank you. Yes, my loves. I'm going to let all of you slowly come back into your world. You went on a beautiful journey. If any of you would like to reach out to me privately and share with me how your journey went, I would love that. If you guys want to even share it on the chat now, you can. Most of the time after a big journey like this, most of us move a little slow or we want to eat. So feel free to eat, drink a lot of water, hydrate. We're working with so many energies. But again, we get to choose to make those as calm as we desire. They don't have to be wavy. We can choose to come in. We can choose to ground. We can choose to be. We can choose to trust. We can choose to flow. So allow yourself to move through whatever transitions you're going through with grace, with presence, with gratitude. Be grateful, even for the change, even for the chaos, even for the pain. Trust it all. And when you trust it all, you find that flow. Sarah says, I feel cleansed and renewed. Thank you, love. Absolutely incredible. Yay. I'm so glad. Yes, please share. I'm a words of affirmation. That's my love language. So if you guys ever want to reach out to me and share how your journey went, I absolutely love hearing it because it's so different on this end when you're just facilitating. Some people don't need it. I don't need it. I love connecting. I feel like it's a way of connecting, of knowing how your journey went, what came through. I'd love to know what got activated, what was on your scroll or your piece of paper, what your guides wanted to tell you. It's a big night. It's a special night. I hope you guys integrate this well. I have a playlist if you guys, I have a whole playlist. If you want it, reach out to me. I created one for remembering with my favorite songs of remembering. Other than that, I love you. And if you want the recording, reach out. I'll be able to get you guys the recording of this for those of you who attended live. It's a gift. You guys can have it. I love you all so much. And I hope you have a magical night. Happy eclipse season, happy new moon, happy manifesting, and here's to remembering who we all really are. I love you. Good night. Thank you, you guys.